Thank you for the invitation and, of course, for bringing opportunity to bring a piece of Bosnian perspective in these pandemic times. When we go back to the freedom of the movement as a fundamental freedom and fundamental right, we saw violations by blanket bans on certain age groups from going outdoors during the crisis, but we also saw freelance journalists who are working for multiple media outlets that actually were affected by not being able to provide a so-called free pass from their employer to do their job and to move inside of the pandemic times. Also, freedom of the expression was violated by introducing law that was prohibiting the spread of panic and disorder during the state of emergency. In other words, in practice, this meant actually censorship, but also monitoring media and information via social networks.
What to say about democratic freedoms? We cannot speak about real democratic freedom with lockdown and police time. It is not a normal democratic pattern of living, definitely. But I believe in our country, these emergency measures were implemented pretty carefully, without misusement, according to the instructions of the World Health Organization and according to main democratic rules and framework. We must say that the restrictions for free movement are having a partly negative impact to civil society, of course, because there is less gathering and direct communication. But civil activists are light on the social media, organizing Zoom events, raising petitions like the one for saving the rivers against small hydro power plants, and also organizing different activities in the environment. And civil society in Macedonia is alive. And is pretty persistent in each situation and in this also. And there are it raises a debate about democracy, hate speech, fake news. When we speak about hate speech, in general, I must say that the news about COVID are shared in our country on a transparent way constantly.
By the beginning of April, we had the first and most, notorious arrest within this period, where a journalist who published a story about the capacities of the healthcare system in Vojvodina, in the north of Serbia, and their limitations, was arrested, allegedly for spreading false information. After the reaction of civil society in Serbia and international organizations, she was released some 48 hours after that, and that that case was somehow closed. In the process, her mobile phone and her laptop were taken away from her, but they were returned soon afterwards.